Today, we are at the Humayun's tomb, which is situated on the Mathura Road near its crossing with Lodi Road at Nizamuddin East in Delhi. Humayun was the second Mughal Emperor of India, who ruled between 1530 and 1540 AD and from 1555 to 1556. This tomb was built by Humayun's first wife, Bega Begum or Haji Begum, 9 years after his death, according to some sources, and 14 years according to others. The chief architect of this tomb was Mirza Ghyas Beg, who was a Persian. The style of building of this tomb was the initiation of Mughal architectural style, which reached its zenith with the construction of Taj Mahal at Agra. The United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO, designated this tomb as the World Heritage Site in 1993. This structure is built with red sandstone along with black and white marble. It was the first example of a tomb surrounded by garden on all its four sides, which was known as Charbagh. The total area of this enclosure is about 12 hectares. The lofty mausoleum is located in the center of the enclosure and rises on the podium faced with a series of cells with arched openings. The roof is surmounted by a 42.5 meter high dome of marble with chhatris placed around it. This is the grave of Humayun. Humayun was initially buried at another place, the Purana Qila, but later his mortal remains were transferred to this mausoleum built especially for the purpose. This tomb contains more than 150 graves of members of the Mughal royal family. Among those lying buried here are Haji Begum herself, Dara Shikoh, Shah Jahan's son, and the later Mughals like Jahandar Shah, Farrukh Siyar, Rafiud Darjat, Rafiud Daula, and Alamgir II. This is why it is also popularly known as the graveyard of the Mughals. Also, it is here from where the last Mughal emperor, Bahadur Shah Zafar, was captured along with his three sons in 1857 by Lieutenant Hodson. William Finch, an English merchant who visited this tomb in 1611 AD, described the rich interior finishing of the central chamber of the tomb. He mentioned that there were rich carpets and a small tent above the cenotaph. The site of this tomb was chosen due to its proximity with the dargah of the famous Sufi saint Hazrat Nizamuddin Aulia, who was much respected and revered by the Delhi rulers.